rock and roll, buddy. Rock and roll, rock and roll, rock and roll. Yeah, rock and roll, rock and roll. Hey, how you doing, pal? Hey, folks. Welcome, Sports Vision, the magazine show.
Janis Joplin. Motorcycle
kicks
music.
It. You know what I'm talking about?
Men's music.
Men's music.
Man stuff.
Man is a man is a man.
We're all dressed up like it for the show.
Hey,
for the show.
Valentine wishes to you and to yours.
Happy all right? Valentine's Day.
You know what I'm saying? A little bit later on, play a little ball. What do you say?
Hey, whatever you do, there's word on the street out there. Now, we just, Joe and I want to clear something up. We started talking about this before the show, and that is, you know, people have been saying that.
Kick that ball.
You know, that because we dressed up like this last night, we did a little deal on it. Supposedly, someone has a tape, but hey, don't believe it. There's nothing out there like that. We did nothing. But
this is just for the season,
so maybe
pal.
Maybe indicate that we're not, you know, masculine or whatever. But, you know, Fajita's here. Come and worship. Fajita's here, and we've got, you know, we're men's men. We are.
Hey, we just joined a men's club.
Shot right there. There it is. She's ready. Joined a men's club.
Men's club. We're going to be working out a lot now.
Got
and
my razor.
Got your, we're going to shave. No foam?
No foam, I'm a man. No foam.
That's what I like to see.
I got last night we did a little bit for the mayor. The mayor, you know, that we had multiple sclerosis. That was a big deal for him.
Mayor has multiple sclerosis?
No, it was a roast. It was a roast for the mayor.
Oh, that's right. We roasted the mayor.
Arrows.
We roasted him right open. Chestnuts roasting on open fire. You know what I'm talking about?
And we are men's men with little Cupid stuff. And we sort of played the game. But
not
hey,
stupid stuff. He said Cupid stuff.
Yeah. Hey, we're going to bowl after the show?
We'll go bowl, play a little cards first.
Play a little cards first.
All right, let's go.
All right, well, first,
what do we got going here?
Tell you what, on this happy Valentine's Day, we're going to talk about all kinds of stuff here. We're going to, first of all, tell you about the region championship.
Oh,
wrestling.
Yeah.
By the way,
wrestling's tough, man.
Man's sport. We're going to talk about the Tennessee Valley Athletic Conference ninth grade championship, girls and boys, elementary basketball, high school basketball, and we got it all. So here we go. Let's take off first with high school wrestling region championships. And we've got it going now. Here's the tape. There it is at Cleveland High School, the region championships. That's Jake West, 119-pound Bradley.
Wild West
going to win him the 119-pound championship in the region one seed headed to the
congratulations,
region.
Loser.
Michael Craig at 1-2 seeds in their region headed to the state tournament coming up this Saturday.
Isn't that a wonderful thing?
At 125-pound.
Two Cleveland guys. There it first is. And second.
9-1 decision, major decision by Michael Cragen over Matt Morgan and Santec bringing us all this action and Matt Killer Keller. This guy is it in high school wrestling.
You're right.
No doubt about it. He's got the McMinn kid that's been ranked number 2 all year and gets me a stick right here against this guy. There is Matt and there is the stick and Santec. Santec's embarrassed. They're going to cover that thing up. They said, man, that was too quick, too fast. And here is 135-pound Alan Morris from Bradley and Alex Curtis of Cleveland, first and second place, respectively, in their divisions at 135 pounds in the region. They are going to head as 1-2 seeds in the state championship coming up this Thursday, Friday, Saturday. You're watching this Thursday night or Saturday morning. Raise these guys, Alan Morris, working on state championship right there. And there is 140-pound Matt Wagner getting best match in this right here. Very good win for Matt. That guy was the first seed. Matt Wagner's going to end up getting first at 140 pounds for Bradley. And Cleveland's first place entry right here, this is Nathan Jones.
What a wrestler.
Picked to win the state tournament.
Yeah, buddy.
145 pounds. Nathan is working his guy over pretty good right here. Came up with a major decision. And
look at him. He's got his dad out there.
Yeah, we're moving on from Nathan Jones to Quinn Freshman Animal Stud.
The Eskimo.
Quinn the Eskimo, the mighty, mighty Quinn. I need to put some background.
Yeah, we need to give him his own thing.
I'll tell you, this guy can wrestle, and he is going to, he's picked to win second in state right now.
A ninth grader.
Ninth grader. He is something else. And there we go now with 160. That is Lee Harris, ended up number 2 seed, 52nd in this. This is the guy that beat him. Can't recall where he's from right now, but Lee Harris at 60, number 2 seed, and this is Breck Steele. Reserve until about a month ago. Took over at 171, winning very, very much here. He's the number 1 seed, 171 pounds. He's also picked a place in the tournament then, state this weekend, Breck Steele. And here is Rusty Blackman, no peers right now at 189. Headed to Oklahoma State, as we've mentioned before. This guy right here has got Josh Bond at 189. He's a very good wrestler. It's just that Rusty is head and shoulders above the field. Josh got number 2 seed there, so he'll be doing good in the state. Keontae Morton, 215, big key, favored to win him a title.
There you go. Look at that. Look at that.
Pinning his man here in the state tournament. And there it is.
There you go. Kiyotse.
Hey, you think you could fight that arm muscle right there?
No way.
And that chin, I'd say I give, right? I wouldn't even fight. Right? Look at that guy. Just killed him. Here we go. Big Lee Jackson. This guy, I'm telling you, he's going to play football at Tennessee Tech. I do not want to be in his way, either on the football field or on the wrestling mat. Look at that. I mean, that's got a burst of air right out there, boy. I'll tell you that right there now. And here we go back around because we got these matches back on the end, got a different tape. This is Adam Raines and Carter Wright, two great wrestlers, both seeded in the tournament. Adam Raines looks good, got a nice draw, should be able to go somewhere. Carter Wright ranked fourth, Adam Raines ranked second, and Adam beats him for 1-2 in the region. Bradley, Adam Raines, number one, Cleveland Carter Wright, number two. That was a very exciting match. Adam Raines comes from behind in the third period to win. And was contending for the best match, but didn't get it. The Wagner match got it. But great wrestling right there. And that's kind of a seesaw all the way with Raines pulling it out. And right there, we go back. We got Jake West. We got a little extra footage, I guess, on Mr. West. He's going to get double time here.
Yeah, buddy.
Not too bad. Here he goes. He's going to turn his man. There he is, Big Jake. And he's got this guy right there. And he's going to end up this corner.
Inside the circle. And there you go, your high school wrestling scoreboard brought to you by Superior Sporting Goods Region 3 High School Wrestling Tournament. We must apologize to the Evans family, Josh Evans. We got there a little late after his match.
Just missed his
match. We didn't get to see his victory.
We'd have had Big Josh on tape.
I'm telling you what. What a wrestler, though, that kid, huh?
Doing good, doing good.
He wrestles like 104 pounds. 103 pounds, Josh Evans from Bradley with the victory. 112 was Adam Raines of Bradley. 119, Jake Wild Wild West from Bradley. 125, Mike Craig. It's nice to hear, isn't it? Too bad it's not Yim. His son, Bradley, 130, Matt Killer Keller from Bradley. 135 victor was Alan Morris of Bradley. 140-pound class, Matt Wagner from Bradley. He had the best match versus Cumberland County in the entire tournament, folks. And 145, go!
Nathan Jones!
Nathan Jones! Go, Jones! Cleveland High School, what a big victory at 145.
Hey, he could kick Robbie Derrick's tail.
You ain't lying, buddy, but who can?
Huh? No, of course, he's got reason to now. Robbie's got reason to be mad, but he couldn't do nothing about it.
Oh, no, are you here kidding me? 152 is Quinn, the Eskimo Gibson from Bradley with a big victory. 171, Breck still, he still is Breck from Bradley. He's a victor.
Who he uses.
Go ahead. Breck. 189-pound class, Rusty Blackman. Oklahoma State bound for Bradley, and we'll go on to the next graphic here as we move on. Look at that heart as it brings you to you. Region 3 High School Wrestling Championship Tournament here, 215 pounds was Keontae Moore of Cleveland. Heavyweight division, Lee Jackson, Tennessee Tech bound from Bradley. Bradley, team won, first place team, 310 points, which is a record, folks.
Region record,
Region 3. Second place team was Cleveland, the Blue Raiders, with 193. Congratulations to both Bradley and Cleveland. You've done us proud, guys. Outstanding wrestler of the entire tournament, Matt Killer Keller from Bradley. Bradley Bears, 11 region champions. Out of 14. Cleveland Raiders with 2 region champions. Again, congratulations to the Bears and the Raiders on a great
out of 14
tournament.
From right here in Cleveland, Tennessee.
And wrestling is such a man's sport, pal.
It is a man's sport. I tell you. Hey, when you get home at night and there's nothing, you know, nobody's home and nothing's going on, you ever sit around and, like, watch John Wayne movies and stuff?
Oh, man, are you kidding all the time? Hey, let me tell you, Pilgrim. See what I'm talking about?
Yeah, you know, and I like Robert De Niro, talking to me.
A little bit of Sylvester Stallone.
Hey, by the way,
Adrian!
We had to do this thing for
the guy thing.
And I was Cupid. My son calls him Hermes. I was Cupid. That's why.
Not stupid, he said Cupid.
So we're supposed to do it for the show. We're doing it for the Valentine's Day. I think we would not
and I'm
really
love.
Enjoy
it. Dr. Love, pal.
Like this looks with all the makeup and stuff because, hey, we're men. We are, matter of fact,
we're men's men.
We're going bowling later.
Hey,
after the show.
Don't hear that rip wasn't anything.
But first of all.
Hey, Mike.
Yeah.
How long we been here, huh?
Yeah, we've been here a long time, looking good. Hey, first of all, we're going to the TVAC 9th grade tournament, Tennessee Valley Championships. Here we go, girls and boys. There it is, and Hardy's is bringing you this, and that is Tristan Reynolds with a basket and foul for Bradley as they are looking good. Bradley girls going, here we go. Reynolds again steals the ball up and in. Now we're going to Tambra Crow. Going to come up here for Bradley. There she is. Big Tambra Crow going to get it right here. The feet in.
Look at that.
Basket. Foul. Good. And Bradley's rolling, and one reason why, Ashley Robinson. Look at this. Turn around, pass to her.
Mr. Robinson.
Or Reynolds.
I'll just sing here.
All right, here we go. Whitney Carroll.
Don't mind me.
Great job, Whitney Carroll. And Reynolds now is going to bomb the three, and it's from downtown Cleveland. It's good. It's 30 to 11 at the half as Bradley rolling in the T-back championship. There's Carroll again, number 33 for Bradley, spotting and scoring. And here we go, nice drive inside and foul. And this is going to be Tambra Crow. Basket counts. Watch this effort. Look at how many shots here Bradley's going to get here on this little
one
series of action. And number 34, finally,
two,
it's going to be a little
three,
bit. Robinson is going to convert for Bradley.
Four.
There it is.
They got a four
there,
shot.
Hitting it hard. And here is 33, Whitney Carroll from way outside. Look at this.
From the Monument Building, right?
Monument Building.
What you usually
five
say, pal.
Cleveland. Number 31, Amanda Burnett is going to pass.
And Amanda, hug and kiss.
Ashley Walker, there it is. Nice feet. 63-34. Bradley would win big, and they are going to be T-back champions now in every grade, because I'm going to show you in a minute the boys are going to come up and win. But 7th, 8th, and 9th tournament champions in the Newport Conference. And there are the all-tournament team. That was Kristen Reynolds. And then we got Whitney Carroll. And then we're going to have Ashley Robinson, all-tournament team for the conference champions, Bradley Bearettes, and the Cubettes, I should say, since we're in the middle school still. And now we're on to the boys' game. There's Cleveland coming out, ready to go. Levante, Tim Cooper, and the rest of the crowd, and Bradley's going to come and join the fray as we're getting ready for a all-area final here in the T-back conference championship. Hardy's bringing you this action, and Bradley versus Cleveland. Going to start out now with Tim Hobbs for Bradley. Tall guy inside. Tall guy puts the ball in the basket. Number 12, Kellen. Don't call me Vlasic. Don't call me Dill. Just call me Kellen Pickle, because I'm going to
just
make
call
that
me
Klossy right there. Pickle again now coming up with the bomb. Look at this guy. First of all, we had the basket by, wait a minute, Cleveland's James Dodd right there. We had Pickle twice in a row. That was Jamichael Dodd.
Hey, come on,
that
come
the
on
shot. And
give
that
him
was Wes Sue. Jamichael Jamade the one earlier. Here we go. That was Tim Cooper who popped for three. Now we're on to Pickle again as it's 10-9 after the quarter. Pickle right here with a nice steal. And look at the adjustment right there. Puts the ball in. Justin Hare. Speaking of adjustments, big brothers taught him well. Hare again. And I'll tell you, that Hare, it's neither here nor there, but we know he's a good ball player.
Oh, man.
Here comes Cooper.
You're sick,
nice
pal.
Speed from Cooper to Levante. Two guys on a football field to compliment each other right there on the basketball court. Same thing. Now Corey, my brother Alfonso Pugh. Corey Pugh sticks the ball in, and it's 24-15 Bradley. And we got Coach Green there, and Coach Lewis, and Coach Cartwright, Green, Cartwright, Lord Green, Bonanza, I don't know. Anyway, 24-15 Bradley. Cooper penetrates, scores, and here's Wes again. Suter taking the garbage right here, turning around, filling the garbage truck, and it is good. Cooper is going to try to keep Cleveland in it. Here he is, Cooper. Look at this. Shake, fake, drive, score. That guy is quick, but here he is, Mr. V, Classic Pickle. Turn around. The guy was in his face. Fades, jumps, spins, shoots, scores, and Pugh scores here right after that bucket from Cleveland. It's 34-21. Now there's the cheerleaders for both Bradley and Cleveland. Here we go.
Now those are just the Bradley cheerleaders.
Bradley, the Cleveland's going to follow shortly.
All right.
Doing their dance, doing their thing, the ninth grade in their final game here as cheerleaders.
See, we would never move like that, because those are females.
No. And you know what, they're dressed that way. We wouldn't normally dress like it. It's for the show.
Oh, for the show is what I'm
see,
saying.
See, they're doing it for the basketball
game. I would never even know how to do that.
Yeah, they're doing that for the basketball game.
See, I couldn't move like that.
No, you couldn't. And if you did, it would be real scary.
It would be.
Yeah, I mean, I wouldn't want you to move like that.
If I had a swing like that, it'd be in my backyard.
That's right.
Or not on me, because I can't swing like that.
Or on a golf course.
Or on a golf course, is exactly right. All right. Back to the ball.
Inside, Hobbs scores, there he is. And Levante Barber from Cleveland's going to answer, saying, hey, I can play some. Hare now with the three. There he is. Fakes the pass. Spots.
Oh, by a hair.
Scores. Suter now. Watch the second effort by Big West. Doesn't get the first one. Banging inside. Getting the ball. Little pump fake. Puts the ball in. Hare. Another bomb. There it is. And it's butter.
Hare today, nice. Gone tomorrow.
There it is. Now
you
Cooper
know what I'm saying?
With the answer. Look at Cooper. Just say, hey, I can do that. Now we're coming to Darrell Wood for Cleveland's going to answer, and it's 47-41.
He would if he could.
Cleveland's closing
he did.
In. and Cleveland's Jamichael Dodd with a basket on a bump shot. Here it is coming up.
Oh, man.
With a bomb again. 3 points. There's Jamichael Jamaican shot. Good.
But silly.
And Hare is going to hit it again for Bradley. There he is. Hare's going to come up with a basket. Nice feed now by West to Alfonso Pugh's little brother. There's West.
There he is.
There it is. He's going to make the basket. And that was from Pugh, I guess. The wet feed was from Pugh. Here's Hare. Look at that. Little stop and jump.
Yeah.
And here we go. Bradley goes on to win 64-52. So Bradley sweeps the series here with Cleveland. 3 wins over them this year. They swept the regular season and now have won the conference championship. With two great ball teams here in the area. 64-62 Bradley. And there's Levante, all tournament Levante Barber for the Cleveland Raiders there. And Tim Cooper as well. Starter for the high school.
That's Rashid Hashim Rashad.
That guy is good, I'll tell you that. Little towel over. Probably wanted to get first. Wasn't too happy with second, but hey, he's a competitor. And there we go with Pickle. Kellen Pickle. The guy can play. And this guy can play. This is Justin.
They all can play, pal.
And this guy can play. Wes Suter.
A little secret.
All tournament, by the way, in both of them. Here he comes, Wes. And then we've got Cleveland getting second right there. Bradley getting first in the T-Vac tournament.
Congratulations to both Bradley and Cleveland. Thank you guys.
Tell us about it, Big Joe.
All right, here we go. T-Vac tournament basketball. T-Vac, Tennessee Valley Athletic Conference. Girls, ninth grade. Lady Cubs, 65. McMinn County, Cherokee, 30.
Hey, Kristen Reynolds, 18 points for the Lady Cubs.
As you can tell, boys, ninth grade. Cubs, 64. Cleveland, 52.
And for Bradley, Justin Hare with 21. And Levante Barber puts in 26 for Cleveland.
There you go, middle school basketball. The girls, 2001 all-tournament team. Kristen Reynolds for Bradley, Whitney Carroll for Bradley, Ashley Robinson for Bradley, and Nicole Martin for Truett. Notice the nice color of blue. And we move on. Let's move on with the graphics here. I think we got another one coming up. Ah, let's go. Hey, am I going to have to break somebody's legs back there? Let's go. Boys, 2001 all-tournament team.
Oh,
Justin
so
had just in time for Bradley. Kellen Blasted, Clausen Pickle for Bradley. West, don't call me Jim Suter, that's my dad, for Bradley. Levante, I used to be a barber, but now I'm a hairstylist from Cleveland. Tim Cooper, Sporting Goods for Cleveland. And Evan, Mickey, and Bernie McGuire from Truett Junior High School. There you go, guys. What are you doing over there? We're back on.
Well, I lost my little, I lost my thing.
What thing?
Don't talk about my lips.
Lost?
Hey, you know, you better save yourself because your reputation is gone.
Hey, come on. You got
but
something else over there? Give me the dog. I'll throw her.
I tell you what. I'm going to be. You know what? The Fonz.
Hey.
The Fonz cool. Was the Fonz not
the
a man?
The Fonz was
he
the man.
He could fight.
He
could do
cool.
anything. I'm going to clear the image here because I don't want people thinking.
What you know, do I got?
Just because we wear this stuff, we wouldn't act that way under any circumstances.
Oh, never. Listen, we're football, basketball, baseball, wrestling. Hey, you know what I got to do? After we leave here, I ran out of gas. I got to go put gas in my car. But you know what I do? I fill it up in my mouth, and then I pour it in, spit it in. That's how tough I am.
Hey, listen, I'm going to work on his car. He's going to gas his car up on the way to commercial here because we do guy stuff. We like to do man
stuff. All right, man stuff. I got to paint a little bit. I got some painting to do.
Commercial.
I got to paint a little bit here. A little bit of painting I gotta do. I'm painting. I'm a man.
People from all walks of life have discovered that Check Into Cash offers a simple solution to one of life's most difficult situations. It happens when an unexpected expense arises and it's just before payday. At Check Into Cash, you write us a personal check and you get the cash you need instantly. We'll hold your check up to 14 days. You can be in and out within minutes. The next time you need quick cash for whatever reason, go to Check Into Cash. It's quick, easy, and confidential.
Call toll-free 1-877-262-CASH for a Check Into Cash store near you.
Treat yourself right to the best tasting biscuits in the good morning light.
Hardee's, America's best-tasting biscuits. Now get two Hardee's made-from-scratch sausage and egg biscuits for just $2. Two for two for a limited time.
Go to Bouncing for breakfast. Nobody can mess. Biscuits and Hardee's.
fresh from scratch, just like Mama did.
Demands on time are ever increasing. That's why over 2 years ago, First Citizens was the first to offer extended business hours. Enjoy drive-through convenience 7:30 a.m. to 7 p.m. weekdays at our Farmland Corners main office and inland locations, with full-service banking 9 a.m. to 12 noon on Saturdays. While some things change, meeting the needs of our community will always be our reason for being. The bank, First Citizens Bank, working harder to make your life easier. Equal housing lender, member FDIC.
I sit at home.
Hey, you got some pliers.
This jacket here, I feel like James Dean, because James Dean's my kind of guy, one of my idols.
It's a and tough guy, wasn't he?
Yeah, you know, there's a pair of pliers. You ever just get a pair of pliers, just want to go just plier things all around the house? You know what I'm saying? Just whatever's there.
Just use pliers on anything.
Hang on a minute, I can't do that.
Let me tell you what I did one time with a pair of pliers.
What's that?
I fixed the electrical box with a pair of pliers. That's all I had.
See? I'm used to working with this guy because I'm a man and I do man type of things, because whatever rumors you hear out there about Joe and I ain't true. That anybody says we did anything that sort of like, you know, make us look a little light in the loafers.
We weren't light. Are you kidding me? We're men's men, man, men's man.
Who's one of your other heroes?
Well, we talked about Rocky. We talked about Al Pacino.
Al Pacino.
Scarface.
Yeah, hey, by the way, you know, when there's nothing to do at home, one of the other things I do,
what?
I just sit around and sharpen my mower blade.
Do you?
Yeah.
You know how I do it?
What?
I go like this. That's how tough I am.
That's a pretty good way to do it. Yeah, that's a pretty good way to do
See
it.
See what I'm saying? I just go right there with the teeth and file it right down.
Speaking of filing things down, we're filing right down the line here, and we're going to go to elementary basketball. By the way, you do look a little effeminate in that outfit,
and
you know, their makeup and all that stuff.
Hey, it's just for the show.
Yeah, it's for the show. We do this for the show. It's all put on.
Do I look?
All right, here
little,
we go. Elementary basketball.
Do I look
another
feminine, really?
Going on. Here we
do
are.
Really
Truett versus Prospect. Look at the long shot by Emily Hilliard back there. Barely see her, but there it is from Truett. Great shot. Prospect number 11, Ashlyn Mason. She's going to
jar
the board, and she jars the basket.
Uh-huh.
Mason again. And now she she throws up a shot and it goes in. Now we got Taylor Garrett, calls for the bank shot and scores. Allison Whaley is going to answer for Prospect, and it's 17-12 at the half. And All-State, Bill and Allen.
This
action. Two of our favorite people. Look at this gal's one.
Well, not really, but we say that because it's fun.
I like this here. Interesting player, number 12 Prospect, Lacey Allen, driving, shooting, good off the backboard, time out. And now we got some Prospect players.
Hey, between you and me, I like Bill, but I'm not crazy about Al.
Yeah, I don't know about Al. Here we go with the Truett girls right there. And the Prospect, look at that little girl.
That is Brad Scoggins. That's not a little girl.
Nice. Here comes Lacey Allen again with the ball, with the basket out in front of the whole crowd. The girl can move. Loose ball now. Watch this. Look at the hustle. Who comes up with it? Allen. Again. Shoots. Fouled. Bucket's good. And, hey, I don't know, a little bit excited there, but if I were to pick somebody to make the next shot, it would be Allen again. And it's 33-14 Prospect over Truett to the boys' game now.
Do they got any Prospect?
Congratulations, North Lee versus Oak Grove coming up in the boys. And there we got the girls shaking hands here first, but here it is, 13. Alex Alalonis puts the ball in, and here's North Lee's Jamie Harper. We'll move inside.
BPA.
Oak Grove, Alex. Ethan Lynn, Oak Grove, Ethan. Basket gets the little victory lap roll there, and here we go, it's Oak Grove again. Taylor Bryant calls back, scores, and it's halftime, and it's cheerleader time. And who's that? That's Joe. That's Joe
Sleeper.
Working right there. And now we're back to action. Oak Grove Bryant now with the basket and the foul. But we're going back to North Lee. Jamie Harper. Basket and foul. Everybody wear 23. They all seem to be good. You know what I'm saying? And here he goes, number 23, Harper again. And again he scores. And again, here we go with some more action as we got the foul there. And did you notice the battery shot? I mean, my wife took here the other day. I think she let the camera roll. But, you know, nice shot on the
battery. That's a good shot of Sneakers.
Players make. And the Coal Environmental brings this Harper shot to you. And he did. Harper Valley PTA. It's in the basket. Alex Alalonis again. And Alex puts it through. And now, the ref talking to the fan. What's supposed to go on?
He's saying, look, if you don't shut your mouth, I'm going to have to throw you out.
I can whip you.
I've had that said to me many, many times by referees.
Northeast Trent Nunley puts the ball in, and here we come back with Northeast Alonis one more time. Oak Grove, Castile banking it off the backboard. Taylor Bryant now for Oak Grove. Scooting, getting the ball, a little pump fake, little score. Now 20 seconds left, and Oak Grove's Castile's going to try to make the game tight. He does. And North Lee's going to hold on to win this thing, though, in a tight one, 32-29. And there's the excitement as they hang on and win and advance into the winner's bracket in the tournament. Great job, and thank you, Ocoee Environmental. And now we're on to North Lee versus Hopewell in the girls' 10 and under. North Lee girls, Hopewell girls, and it's Emily Jones. She scores
likely,
for Hopewell.
Likely name.
As Coach there she is, Chelsea Blackburn right there first.
Chelsea Clinton.
That's right. And Blackburn beats Heather Finnell there and Zoe Atchley for Hopewell. And here we are with Chelsea Blackburn with the bomb. Northeast Jones steals the ball. She's going to go all the way. I was behind one person there, but we'll catch up. Haley Urban now for North Lee. Here comes Haley. Right
Haley's
there.
Comment.
Haley hits the backboard and in. Good job by Haley. And Hopewell's up 17-13.
How'd you know?
Now here's Jones again. Lays it in. Anna Thomas now is going to bring one in for North Lee. There's Anna. There's the basket. And nice inbounds play to Haley Urban from Brooke Gray, Allen's daughter. Nice pass inbounds there. North Lee within two. 24 with the foul shot. Right there, and it's going to make it. And they're going to have another foul shot. It's just a two-point game. It's going to put them up. Blackburn again, and she converts. And now Thomas is going to answer for North Lee. There's Thomas with the basket. And Blackburn, though, now with just a one-point lead, she's going to put the ball in. And North Lee's Erin Burkhart, though, is going to come back and cut it back to one again, going coast to coast.
Dale Earnhardt.
Yeah, well, we know that guy, too. And Burkhart again is going to come down and score. There she is, trying to get North Lee back. North Lee undefeated up to this point now. We got a tight game. North Lee's going to call timeout. Down one, saying, hey, come on, we've got to come in. 28,
down
25,
three.
Down
three. Not one.
After a couple of Hopewell free throws, they were down one right there. Then a couple of Hopewell free throws. Made it a three-point game. Two free throws now by North Lee Jones. She's going to convert them both. Watch this. Talk about the steal. Third of the steal. Drops it through. She's going to cut it to one. And it's just a few seconds left on the clock. Here she is. Jones again. Basket good. A couple seconds left, but Heather Fennell is going to score and puts it out of reach. Last nail in the coffin. North Lee takes their first loss of the season, and but they still can go back and win because that's their first loss in the tournament. They go through the loser's bracket there and come back and win. A nice win for Hopewell. Boys game, Stewart versus Waterville, and that was Cody Goins and Watson Horner jumping for the ball. And guess what? Watson Horner is going to make the first basket of the game. And Goins now is going to make the first basket for Stewart. So the tip-off boys make it. Well, and here's Waterville's Brandon Phillips now. Here he goes, and he fills it up. Steal now by North Lee. He's going to take it all the way, and that's Chad DeLuca. Here he is. And that was DeLuca on the turnaround coming up right here. There's DeLuca. And a loose ball now, and alert guy here, Edgar Cordero, is going to find who? DeLuca? There he is. There's Cordero.
Cindy Lou,
there's
who DeLuca. Is no more than two.
And Cordero to DeLuca one more time at the buzzer. There it is. Buzzer goes off. 12-8 now. Stewart at the half. And here it is. There's Cordero to DeLuca there on that second feed. It's in. Good job right there. And it is now 12-8 at the half. Stewart with the lead. Stewart cheerleaders. Looking good. Doing a little dance for you. Shake and bake and getting the fans worked up, and we're going to move on to the Waterville girls. equal time. And there they are with the Waterville shuffle. And Matt Cohen now. Matt Cohen with the J. And then here's Watson Horner. We know this guy. And, you know, that looks like his dad's logo right there.
It is.
And there we go now with Horner again working inside. There he is. He's got the ball off the inbounds play. Puts it through. And here we go. There's a timeout. That looks like Sam Horner helping coach. That can't be Sam Horner, is it? I think it is. Helping them coach. And whatever he said, it worked. And Cordero spots up for the J for North Lee. And Kobe Dills is going to try to bring Waterville back.
It's another pickle. Isn't any related
there
to Kelly Pickle?
Dill, Kobe Dill, Dill Pickle.
Whew. That was a mouthful.
A pickle talk there.
A lot of pickling in there.
Yeah, I relish
that. Somebody was going to get put out at third.
I'm going to say it again. I relish that. Never mind. Okay. Hey, we're going to have a 10 and under.
I heard you the first time. I just let it go
right. 10 and under.
Champions.
Champions. We're going to be showing them next week. We got our man that's in there directing right now going to cover Friday and Saturday, and we're going to get that.
How tough I am. Look at this.
By the way, let's.
Castrol.
Scott Curator. Yeah, that's right. Pretty manly stuff. I drink. That's right. Drink it straight. All right, here we go. Wrestling champions we talked about. By the way, the reason we're going to show you this will get you in the mood because we're going to show the state tournament. And we're going to give you a graphic afterwards. So go get your pencil while you're going to see these champions stepping up here on
I'm
the medal
melting,
stand.
Because
these are 13 Cleveland area kids. They're going to be in the region, or the one that were placed in their region.
I don't
going
even
to go to the
care
state
if I messed up my lipstick.
And huh? You go get a pencil because we're going to tell you the times right after this. You're going to see it
I'll
all
mess it up. I don't
week.
Even care.
Take a look at these wrestling champions. Here we go. There it is, brought to you by our buddy Ray at True Line, and that is the 103, and that is the Josh Evans by the coach, Steve Logston, handing him his black as Joe makes all kinds of garage and...
I'm just fixing the set, Mike.
Adam Raines right there, you saw Big Adam, who was the winner of the 112 along with Carter Wright in second. And right there's 119, Jake West. Nobody's looking for him, but I'm sure he's going to do well. And there is Michael Cragen at 125 and Matt Morgan. First and second place right there in the region. Matt Keller, 130. Enough said. Championship coming. There's Alan Morris, quarterback, Bradley High School. Championship coming. Here we go, Matt Wagner at 140. Guys going to place, I promise you. That two-line race says, look at Nathan Jones. Nathan Jones is going to win for Cleveland at 145 pounds. And Quinn Gibson, freshman, placed very high, looking to be in the finals there. And Breck.
You need anything repaired at your house, Mike?
Breck is going to place. And Rusty, I'm undefeated Blackman. Looks like the Grim Reaper right here, don't he? And here he is.
Would you ever call him Baldy?
No, I wouldn't. Speaking of a tough guy, that's Keontae Moore, 215, going to win it.
Would you call him Baldy?
Jackson. And he's going to win it. And there is Matt Keller winning his Outstanding Wrestler of the Tournament Trophy. Shook hands there with Coach Al Miller of Cleveland. Al Miller's Cleveland team, second place in the tourney. They're going to stand there for a little picture taken from all the fans and parents standing around. We got a little side view. I'm going to get all the faces on there. And look at Howard Langford going to jump up on the medal stand. Assistant coach did a great job there helping Al with that team. Al will tell you that he can beat anybody on.
I was going to say, have you noticed how all of Al's wrestlers are taller than he is?
That's right. And there you go with the Bradley team winning first place in the region, accepting the region championship trophy from Al Miller.
If I was Al, I'd hang around with Brad Scoggins. What do you say?
And there's the Al.
He looked like
Bradley
a giant.
Wrestling team has two-line Ray. And there he is, the podium.
Looked like a giant.
Tell you what, graphics coming up because we're going to tell you when
we
and
go.
Where. Here we go, Joe. We're putting this on TV.
We are, pal. State championships high school wrestling be held at McClellan Gym in Chattanooga, UTC campus. We're going to air this Wednesday, the 21st of February, 8 p.m. and 11 p.m. You can catch it at those times. And then on Friday, the 23rd, you got to excuse me, I was just eating a kiss. 23rd of February. We're going to be airing that at 8 p.m. You'll be viewing it at 8 p.m. I'll view it, too, if I watch it. Saturday, the 24th of February, 1 p.m. is when you can watch it. And, of course, it's all on WTNB.
I just can't explain it, what the reason was. Why, you know, the other night, the way I... Wait. Once I got going, I don't know what is the music. It made me feel so...
Gay?
Happy. It just made me feel happy. Yeah. Yeah, I'm working...
It was the
basket.
Was the music.
It was the music.
Music. Hey, I gotta go change your tire.
Hey,
you got a couple of minutes?
No, listen, we gotta get to the next story.
I gotta change it.
Charleston.
I gotta change
the
tire.
Charleston the other night, last game.
I've gotta change the tire. Plus, it's a man thing to do.
Tell them about the big event in Charleston.
Oh, yeah, yeah, yeah.
Teleco coming.
I can do the tire in a minute.
Teleco whipped him the other night. Weeped him the other night.
Weeped him.
And our buddy Mike Shires, though, was there for the return match, the grudge match.
Hey, watch
with
this.
All of Look the people from Charleston, past teams.
If you weren't a man, you couldn't do
teams,
that.
Present teams, Charleston basketball doing very good in both boys and girls, and it was
Charleston.
A big event, and we're going to put a lot of this on a coach's show, but you can get a preview of it right now. Take a look at the last basketball game in Charleston.
We love you, Panthers! Panthers!
Teleco Plains at Charleston. We pick up the action in the second quarter. Leslie Davis nails the two, and Charleston's up 16-11. Now down one, Heidi Rominger finds Renee Crick underneath. Panthers lead 18-17. 1:25 left and a half. Mika Jones ties the game at 21. Bit of controversy. Listen for the whistle and the horn. Rominger's shot beat the horn, but the ref blew his whistle first to end the half, so no basket. 21 all at the break. Second half, Josiane Robinson finds a cutting Ashley Turner, who rattles it home for the 2-point lead. Later in the third, Jones running the floor for Teleco to tie it at 25. And then Heidi Rominger will take the ball between defenders and finish it off with the drive, the hoop, and the foul. The conversion puts Charleston up 28-27. Now in the fourth, Brittany Swenson banks home two of her 14 to give Teleco the 31-28 lead. Under five to go, Rominger drives to make it a 33-30 game. Turning point of the game here, 1:30 to go, tied at 33. Davis misses a free throw, but Turner grabs the rebound, gets fouled, and when Teleco argues, they get teed up. The fans like that, Charleston likes that, and then Charleston's Turner will hit four straight free throws, and the Pantherettes are up 37-33. A couple more free throws down the stretch, sealed it for Charleston as they upset number 9 Teleco 41-37. After the game, Coach Slater said a change in the game plan and hard work in practice paid dividends.
When we played Teleco, our second game of the season, they beat us by 27 points. And they beat us last Friday by 10. And we had decided that if we would just slow down the pace of the game and do that, that we would give ourselves a chance to win. Free throws did come through. At the beginning of the season, we were having a really tough time with them, but we've practiced a lot on them. Make the girls concentrate, and now it's paying off because we've been shooting 65, 70, and above percent from the foul line. Well, you know, this was a big night. This is the final home game that Charleston High School Pantherettes will ever have because of our school closing. And so it was a really emotional type thing. It was our last home game for seniors. It's been a real unique experience tonight, and I think that kind of helped get the girls fired up. We had a good crowd backing us. We had a great student section, and it was just, everything was just good tonight.
Between games, they honored various members of the school, including cheerleaders, the Pantherettes, and the Panthers. Former Panthers and Pantherettes were also invited down on the floor for recognition themselves. But enough of the mushy stuff. It's time to get your game face on. Time to get pumped. Because for Charleston, it's the last time they'd ever run out onto this floor for a game. And you never, ever want to close a building with a loss. Jonathan Kyle got the first last basket of the night. He'd finish with 9 points. Jonathan Moses, someone's got to tell this kid it doesn't do any good to look after you pass the ball. Gary Taylor will finish. We're tied up here. Later in the second, Justin Rominger finds Tyler Fennell. It's 16-14 Teleco. Fennell again hits for three, and Charleston has the 17-16 lead. Then just before the half, Fennell gets fouled, hit head to the line, and sink both. And the Panthers would head into the locker room, owners of a 22-21 halftime lead. Then second half, Damian Berdansky ties the game at 25 for Teleco. It's 34-25 now. Teleco and Fennell hits the three to close to a 6-point game. Rominger will step back, and it's 38-31. Fourth quarter now on the break. Fennell to Schnebel, it's 43-37. And then Rominger again with the three, and he's fouled. He missed the conversion though, but it's still a 4-point game. Under a minute now, Rominger gets the steal and lays it in. Charleston down two. still down two. Rominger will drive. He'll miss, but Jonathan Kyle is there. We're tied at 55. 8 seconds left. Teleco has a chance to win. It's up. It's in. No, it's out. And we're heading to overtime. Rominger just taking over, drives the basket and the foul. Charleston up three. And then Josh Shemlin will take it, drive the lane. Panthers up 60-57. Instant replay. Nope. Shemlin again. Cleveland leads by five. And the Panthers would hold on to win by an overtime score of 64-62. A hard-fought overtime victory closes the building in style. And after the game, Coach Tucker said they deserved the break on the missed shot to go to overtime.
We hadn't had a bounce, and it was about time. I agree with you. I thought it was going to go in, too. But once they hit that rim and lay down, you're in trouble. And especially with that new synthetic ball, because it's not slick. He's going to land. He's going to hit that board and come right off. But, hey, I appreciate everybody coming out. And, you know, I know there's a lot of memories and dreams going through there. My high school coach came down and watched this, in which he coached here. And it was, you know, the last game of overtime. And a lot of people out. And, it was great, great.
There you go. Great coach there, and Coach David Tucker of the boys Charleston Panthers. And there you go. High school basketball action last week. This is what you saw. Bradley beating McMinn County 68-46. Bradley now District 5 AAA champs boys.
And in that game, Alfonso Pugh, 28 points.
And girls action. A little revenge coming up here last night. But Teleco beats Charleston last week 51-41. Charleston over Christian Academy, 61-25. And Bradley,
Turner, both those games. Ashley Turner in Charleston Teleco game, 15 points. And in the Christian Academy game, Ashley Turner and Jessica Brooking with 13 points apiece.
I didn't mean to step on your tippy toes there, pal.
Well, you know, you're always on yours. Oh, yeah. Never mind.
Bradley, the girls, the Barretts beating McMinn County, 53-44. The Barretts, District 5 AAA champs.
And Brittany Jackson, 28 points.
Brittany, very, very pretty Jackson.
That's
there.
Right.
She moves on to UT coming up here.
Here we go.
Let's move on to the next graphic. As you can see, look at the colors there, color schemes. Isn't that nice? This was just recent, as of last night. Boys action, it was Cleveland over Ottawa, 63-53, beating Ottawa by 10. Go ahead.
Big Cameron Wesley, 21 points.
Bradley beating number one seed Brainerd.
Number one in the state, not number one seed.
Yeah, that's right, number one in the state. 67-51.
With Alfonso Pugh, 21 points and 18 boards.
And Pugh did not stink in that ballgame, did he?
That's right, he looked good.
Charleston over Teleco, 64-62, by two. Go ahead.
Go ahead.
You don't have anything on that? All right. Girls action, it was Bradley Barretts over Brainerd, 75-48.
Brittany Jackson, 19 points. Brett Hollipa, 15.
Cleveland over Ottawa, Lady Owls, 63-50.
And it was Marisha Hickey with 19 points for Cleveland.
And see, just as I told you, Charleston beating Teleco, 41-37.
And it was Ashley Turner once more with 18 points in a great big ball game.
Ashley Turner, what a wonderful, wonderful basketball player. Baseball 2001 Dixie Baseball registration. If you want to sign up for Dixie Youth Baseball, Saturday, February 24th, 10 a.m. to 4 p.m. at the Industrial Park. Monday, February 26th, Friday, March 2nd. It's going to be 5 to 7 p.m. Saturday, March 3rd, 10 a.m. to 4 p.m. Monday, March 5th, and Thursday, the 8th, from 5 to 7 p.m. as well. And we want to thank our good buddy, our sports director. You can come back to us now because we're here. Our good buddy, Mike Shires, for providing us with the footage there of the Charleston Teleco games. And what are you doing, pal?
I'm calling my wife here.
For what?
If she'd answer the phone.
For what?
Hey, Denise. Denise.
What do you need or what?
I just wanted to be sure. Can you get down here for a minute?
A little hen pecked,
don't you think? And I've got the Valentine's Day present to give you, dear.
Where is she? What are you doing? Why are you calling your wife?
Because I want her to come down here.
Where is she?
I've been married 20 years.
Where is she?
Well, she's driving down here.
From where?
From home.
Sure. From the house?
Yeah, okay. What do we got next? We've got to get ready here for just a moment to go to
Where do you live? In the library? Across the hall?
What took you so long? Check out right here, my beautiful wife of 20 years going on 20 years.
I had to run all the way.
Denise Craig.
Why'd you run?
I've been married.
Where'd I run from?
Well, why did you
run?
What's
you so long?
Well, because it's busy out there.
What's busy?
What?
We got Christmas shopping going on?
Was it a pile up on Key Street or what?
Yeah.
Again?
Say the lines. Okay.
You write them for
it. Uh-huh.
Good. Hey, another question. One question I got to ask you while we're sitting here talking. Don't you embarrassed with him wearing this little getup? What is that? You're kidding me.
He prances around that way all the time.
Please, not on TV. God, I've been married 20 years to this lady right here. And I'm
nine happy years.
Happy years, 20 years married. And speaking of happy, we're going to go to a very masculine and good friend of mine, athlete of the week.
Happy as in gay?
Shay Blair. Commercial!
Since 1906, Cleveland Bank and Trust has helped many people like Kay Jenkins build and purchase homes in our community. Our experienced mortgage specialists offer the most competitive interest rates available and a wide range of mortgage options. Whether you're buying a new home or refinancing an existing mortgage, Cleveland Bank and Trust helps you fulfill your dreams of home sweet home. Cleveland Bank and Trust is part of your life, all day, every day. Member FDIC, Equal Housing Lender.
Cleveland Chiropractic Clinic offers complete chiropractic care. Dr. Russell Smith and his friendly, dedicated staff can help relieve chronic back pain, neck pain, headaches, allergies, and also sport-related injuries. Cleveland Chiropractic Clinic has a licensed massage therapist on staff and two certified in-house x-ray technicians. Complete insurance filing is available and 24-hour emergency care. Phone 472-1140.
Man, I am running short on cash with the car repairs, and our wedding anniversary is coming up next week. I need some cash, fast. But from where? I know. Matt was telling me about how First Southern Cash Advance helped him.
May I help you?
He just wrote them a check, and he got the cash right away. That's easy. I can do that. Then First Southern holds your check until your next payday.
It's quick, confidential, and helps take care of life's really important things.
First Southern Cash Advance. Cash when you need it most.
What? I'm cutting wood here, Mike.
We gotta go to athlete.
I'm cutting wood.
Athlete of the week.
I'm masculine. I'm trying to cut wood.
Man, what are you doing?
I'm trying to cut wood here.
Set for God's sakes. I mean, it's a athlete of the week.
I was trying to cut some wood.
Thanks once again to Alan Jones and Checking the Cash. People over there do such a fine job sponsoring this segment. And also Tommy Caldwell at Cooper's Trophies and Plaques. He keeps us provided with the plaques. And today, our Athlete of the Week, standing next to me, is Shay Blair, Bradley Central basketball senior this year. Shay's had an outstanding year. Shay, a member of last year's team that went to the finals in the state. Hoping they can do that again this year. Shay, a great game last night, upset number one. I'm not sure it was necessarily an upset because y'all are playing such good ball, but upset number one Brainerd last night. Tell me a little bit about that ball game.
Last night we played a good game. We came out. We knew they were. Last night was the first night that they went number one in the state, and they beat us at their place. And since 3 years I've been here, there hasn't been a team that has beat us twice in 1 year. And they came to our home court last night, and we played a good game, and we came out with a good victory.
Able to take care of business. Coach Smith says that you're such an integral part of this team this year, and you've have had to step up. You lost three big seniors last year with Hare and Carpenter and Stacy, and you know, of course, you've had to assume a bigger role. Even though you had quite a bit of a role last year, this year you've kind of had to step it up. What did you do to kind of get your game going?
Last year we lost, I think Coach Smith said 57% of our scoring, and this year I just, over the summer, where I just played AAU, you know, and I just worked on my shot and just worked on everything, you know, becoming an all-around player, becoming to shoot the ball better, just being a better offensive threat. And we got other scoring threats on our team, Al and Josh Jones and Jason is becoming a scoring threat now. And I think we're just all just stepping up now and just be realizing our roles.
Well, if you haven't seen him, he's awful quick out there. Great three-point shot. Big spark plug for the team, plays great defense. Shay, have you been playing since you were a little kid, maybe in the in elementary leagues, or when did you start?
Yeah, I started about when I was 7 years old. I used to play at the community center. And ever since then, I've been keep on.
Okay, well, Shay, we'd like to go ahead and get some recognition here for your mom and maybe a couple other members of your family. Behind us, if you can't see, there's a big Valentine's in Shay's locker here. Mom remembered him today. Why don't you go ahead and remember her, give us her name and father and brothers and sisters again.
My mom's name is Lorraine McClary. I live with my uncle. His name is Richard McClary, her brother. And I have two sisters. Their names Tashina and Constance, and they go to Cleveland. And when we play Cleveland, they like to say Cleveland's gonna win and stuff like that. But yeah, I just like to thank my mom. She's real special in my life. If you don't know her, then she's probably at the game. She's always screaming, you know, helping me to get up. You know, when I got a bad game, she's there for me, tell me next time I have a good game and stuff like that. And about my uncle too. He's a real special person in my life. I just like to thank him for everything he's done. I love him. I love all my family.
We're great supporters of you, and maybe kind of take over for Kent Smith's role a little bit now and then, coach you a little bit from the bleachers. Well, Shay, they've done an outstanding job in raising you, and an outstanding job you've done this year in the basketball court for Bradley Central. I know Coach Kent Smith's been very pleased with your performance this year. Therefore, we're going to give you a SportsVision hat, and also I want you to make sure you go as far as you can this year with Bradley, and we thank you for being our Athlete of the Week.
Thank you, SportsVision, for making me Athlete of the Week.
That sawdust all over that hurt you.
Hey, I hope nobody saw that tape.
Well, you know what? We just deny it.
It's
that Sam Cooke music. It kind of makes me.
Oh, it makes me. It gets me like that, too.
I'm telling you, Sam Cooke. I can't help myself.
I've got.
If anybody gets.
Hey, I got a screw.
It's not Shea Blair.
I got a screw loose. I got a tight.
A man's man. The guy's played some great basketball.
I throw those pliers down there like a man does. Look at that. That's how a man.
Football. We like
the man tap. What tape? What are you doing? No tape.
No tape.
Don't roll the tape.
Somebody block the screw.
Oh my goodness!
They can't
roll the tape.
They can't do it.
I believe we're ready for the rebuttal here. We have a very special song for you.
Did you bring your harmonica?
I just cannot believe they're showing this tape tonight. What are we going to deny? It's on TV.
One, two. Happy Valentine's to you. Happy Valentine's to you. Happy Valentine's, Mr. Mayor. Happy Valentine's to you. I can't do that for two very good reasons. Excuse me. That was the first one. First of all, we all want to say that we are so pleased in how Mr. Mayor is doing so well after his surgery. The first reason. The second reason is.
And we got it. We got to act. We got to tell him.
How are we going to tell him it's an act when they're seeing it right on TV? I mean, come on. Come on, Mike.
We just can't. I don't believe it.
He's always bragging.
Yeah.
Well, I just wanted to tell you that
I'm telling you something right now, Mike. I'm telling you something. When I get a hold of Scott.
So do with me what you
I'm
will.
Just, you know what scares me? What scares me is people watching this. I mean, people that we know that are good friends of ours watching this, what are they going to think?
It's the music that does it. I know.
Sam Cooke.
We'll leave now.
It's got time, right, Stan? Okay, we're shaking our hand.
And that, ladies and gentlemen, was Mikey Cragen and Joey Powell.
Who's this fair guy? Does he have a Y on the end of his last name?
Yeah. Okay, Joey. Yeah. SportsVision. TV. And they're hurting for something to do. Yeah.
He's very unfair, if you ask me.
Of course, if you've ever seen their show, this is the best outing they've had.
Appliance Factory Warehouse is your headquarters for GE appliances.
Come in and see all the quality GE products at our huge showroom located next to Blockbuster Video. We now offer the new GE Advantium series, the biggest innovation in cooking products in over 50 years. Appliance Factory Warehouse and GE, serving the Cleveland area proudly for 20 years.
Appliance Factory Warehouse, where the time saving, money saving, sanity saving store.
Hey, we did that for the mayor. It was a good cause. It was just
for the mayor, for the Multiple Sclerosis Society.
There was an act. I mean, you know, football,
like
bowling.
That. Bowling.
Yeah. I mean, it was for a cause. You know.
Hey,
enjoy this.
Watch how tough he is.
Wait.
Boom.
What is it?
It's not that song. Cupid, draw back your bow.
Is that Cook's song?
Again?
I can't help myself.
Straight to my lover's heart.
Oh, Mike, why did they,
I don't know.
Why are they playing that, Mike? Why are they playing that song?
Let your arrow fly straight to
oh, goodbye, everybody. We'll see you next week. Don't like the song, Mike.
I don't mean to love you, but I'm in distress.
Oh, it makes me want to hold a baby.
There's danger of me losing all of my happiness.
Oh, my.
Doesn't know I exist.
Oh, thank you.